So I wanted to talk about regarding two games, Days Gone and World War Z. If you did not know, World War Z actually officially received an official launch date, and it will be indeed coming out on April 16, 2019. But here's the problem. Days Gone has officially confirmed its release date before this, and it was April 26, 2019. So this already clarifies that both of these similar, some sort of similar games will be coming in April of 2019, and like what, 10 days prior? And so this actually makes it a big problem, in my personal opinion, that Days Gone will be coming out 10 days later than the World War Z, but they are both concentrated as a horde type of zombie games. I understand that Days Gone has a freaker, not zombies, but whatever. Basically, Days Gone and World War Z, there still has a lot of similarities towards each other. Now, one of the biggest few that Days Gone is concentrated as a single player, story-driven, solo character, and goes for the World War Z, though, is a multiplayer-driven character, not far from Left 4 Dead or Left 4 Dead 2. And so they obviously been both of these games been in development for quite a while, making these sort of games. Now it was not the re now the problem with it is just that these two games coming out in somewhat similar time range, and that actually makes a big concern that there will be a particular voting more or less happening from the people's perspective and saying which game to get which, right? If you want to get a multiplayer zombie type of game, horde mode and shooting the zombies, like obliterating them at them and stuff, and very quick zombies, actually goes similar for Days Gone, but anyway, you can get the World War Z game in April 16th, sorry. But Days Gone, you cannot play this on multiplayer as a multiplayer, of course. But you can indeed play it as a single player driven story. So it's April 26th. So that's just like concerns and brings out the warnings in pe many people's eyes and minds. Basically, one other thing that a lot of people are already sick of the zombie title games, right? Every year there is at least one particular game that's all about zombies or horde mode or mutated, infected creatures or whatever, right? It's just, there's always this particular motive that people are just like, oh my god, I'm sick of this. You know, actually, believe it or not, Battle Royale is already receiving this sort of flack as well. Battle Royale in a few years will be looked at it similarly as zombies are being looked at it now. The zombie game? I don't feel like playing it. Too many zombie games. Oh, Battle Royale game? I don't feel like playing it. You know, after a few years, even now, some people already, they're like sick of it, you know? Makes sense. It's just that, you know, if you saturate these games, if you overdo them, if you too many of these zombie games, too many of these battle royale games, people get sick of them. And so people wait for the next best big thing anyway. I don't know particularly, in my general opinion, if this is a good thing or bad thing regarding these two games coming out at a similar time. I understand that these two games have some sort of different elements in them, and maybe that actually attracts for many of the gamers that to pick up one or the other game. Maybe, hell, you will go for both of these. If you did not know, big thing, actually, World War Z will be coming out on all the platforms, but Days Gone exclusively to PlayStation. That's actually kind of already brings out like, oh, Xbox guy will be just going for the Xbox version, right? Maybe PC, you go for the PC, so they will get World War Z. Days Gone, well, only PlayStation guys can get it, you know? And so that, maybe it's a good thing, maybe it's a bad thing. I personally don't think it's a good approach for either of these two games, but personally, again, Days Gone has been first to announce that April 26th is going to be their launch date. Until then, few days ago, World War Z announced that they're gonna be launching more or less beside Days Gone. And that kind of gives a competition. Maybe it's a good thing, some approaches, but I personally think that the bigger the gap, the better it could have been, you know, to have people interest, you know, to freshen up, if that makes sense. I don't know, maybe they are very worried that it's just another zombie game that people will be thinking about it. It's like, oh, I don't wanna get it. And so they will want to get one, but they're not going to get the second one. But in here, they're coming out somewhat of a similar date. And so they have like the decision to make, go for this or the other, you know? I don't know, because as well, World War Z is coming out 10 days earlier, So actually maybe a lot more people will go for World War Z first, and it is coming on more platforms. Days Gone will only on PlayStation. So maybe more people will go for a PlayStation version of the Days Gone instead of World War Z on PlayStation 4. Who knows? This is people's opinions, people, gamers have their own minds and they can make their own decisions. Personally, I already know which one I would be going for. It's Days Gone, it's easy. Particularly, I did not really think that World War Z intrigued me too much. It didn't actually look pretty incredible regarding how the zombies can stack up on each other and like climb up the walls. Actually, Days Gone was not far from it as well. but still. Tell me down in the comments which of these two games you would actually get, if at all would get, and maybe you'll get both of them, who knows. Also, please do consider donating on my subscriber star or GoFundMe page. All the links will be down below in the description. Perhaps maybe you want to take a look at my Twitter, it is @ZDEyeT. Or, one other thing, take a look at my community tab page. I always upload and say, you know, have a conversation daily, even more than that sometimes. And we can have some healthy discussions down there. Anyway, like and subscribe as I mentioned. Please do hit that bell notification at the side. I'll see you guys later. Have an awesome day. And yeah, have a good one. You casting on my promises. You know I'm too jealous.